Ladies and gentlemen, the team of Mitchelton Scott. A very warm welcome to the Giro d'Italia here in Israel.
Getting some good pictures, Sam.
Please allow me to introduce myself. I'm a man of wealth and taste. I've been around for a long, long year.
Are you dying to get going, mate?
I cannot wait. We've been hearing a lot of Mitchelton Scott chants whenever another team's gone up the podium, so I think it's time to excite the fans. They've been disappointed every time we haven't gone up.
It's the Giro d'Italia, 101st edition of the Tour of Italy, and for the first time ever, it starts outside the boundaries of Europe. Yes, we're in Jerusalem.
All right, welcome to the first stage of the 101st Giro d'Italia. We've got a relatively short time trial stage today. It's going to be a little bit technical, it's short, but it's a time trial that suits our guys, so let's see what happens.
Cool.
Good track?
Tricky course, man, yeah.
Bumpy and slippy.
Yeah, bumpy and slippy and up and down and left and right. It's going to be a wild course for sure.
It is a little bit bumpy, but in all in all, it's pretty safe. Pretty flowing, corners aren't too bad, up and down. Good all-rounded course, actually. Cool through the streets here as well.
I've lost my luscious locks, unfortunately. It's a bit of a regretting decision, to be honest. But the heat's quite intense here, so I thought I might as well lose some hair and get some cooling back on top of my head. The course is pretty good. It's interesting, eh? There's already been some crashes, so I think for a rider like myself, it'll be all about just being smooth and consistent and getting through today safely. I think there's no risk. The no unnecessary risk needs to be taken today. But it makes for an interesting start for the spectators as well as for the GC contenders.
Excited at the first stage, nice parkour in the city, very technical, and yeah, also very slippery, so...
Finally here, it's a little bit warmer than we expected, since we've been in Israel here, but no, it should be okay. It's only 10 kilometers, so we'll give it a go. It's actually a lot more difficult than I was expecting. The climbs are much more harder and the descent is super fast. I think it should be better for me than your typical prologue, which is super flat. So, we'll see. Come off it, squeeze, past the checkpoint, squeeze, and then you come back and you go, and you basically finish from there anyway.
Over now. 2 seconds. 3 seconds.
Oh, good, Yatesy. Good.
Very good.
Oh, what a performance this is from Yates. Crosses the line in fourth position. What a ride by Yates. Concedes only 18 seconds to Ryan Dennis.
Yeah, extremely happy. I put a lot of hard work in, many, many hours and many kilometers on the TT bike. Finally, some work, the work paying off. I think once we saw the course this morning though, it actually suited me a lot better than we were expecting. So, extremely happy.
Yeah, I don't know the result yet, but I think it's a good start for the team. We are happy, we start already, so we are on the ready now for the race. It's exciting to be part for the history and start in Jerusalem, the first time the Giro d'Italia start out of Europe.
All right, that's a wrap from the first day prologue time trial in Jerusalem. A very good one. Probably Simon Yates is probably best ever time trial to finish seventh place. On a course that was technical, and he took some very calculated risks, and it certainly paid off. Our other boys were in a good place. We wouldn't like to lose much time, and if you gain on any time, it's always a bonus. So, all in all, a good start to the Giro.
What are we doing, Swain?
What are we doing, Swain?
Oh, here we go. Good prezzo?
That was actually alright, yeah. A lot of guys, a lot of fans.
A lot of people.
Yeah.